if Paul wrote to a community of Gentiles that were predominantly Gentiles, that part, it's no question there. We don't have to use history. We can use the internal evidence from the book of Romans at the very end, where he just lays out all of his greetings and use that as a snapshot of the congregation. There's mostly Gentile makeup there. No problem. And that's a good thing that we have a lot of Gentiles who are hearing the gospel and being brought into the Messianic communities. But what impacts our study and appreciation for how much Paul is going to appeal to the Gentiles to continue to stay connected to their Jewish brothers is kind of affected by how many Jews we think are still in the congregation. Is he really feeding into what we would today refer to or recognize as the split between the church and the synagogue? In other words, if the Jews got kicked out of Rome and there was really no strong Jewish presence, why would Paul really even worry or want or imply that the Gentile Christians should connect to Jewish communities, stay connected to them, reaching out to them, fellowshipping with them to some degree? All of that is it forms the background to, is Paul teaching a law-free gospel? Is he teaching Gentile Christians to kind of, what do we say, strike out on their own and figure it out on their own outside of the existing people group of God known as Israel? Has God replaced Israel with the Gentile Christians? Those are all questions that get brought up as we look at the background and historical audience to this letter. My conclusions that I came to as I look at point number two was we may not know exactly how many people were there because of fractured and fragmented historical accounts, but using the resources that I have come to appreciate, the Mystery of Romans book that I've been using by Mark Nanos, his suggestion is that in the end, it's like there's a strong possibility and even a strong probability that all the Jews didn't just pack up and leave in the short space of time that Emperor Claudius said, get up and get out. Wasn't really practical. There were lots of barriers or lots of hurdles or things that would have prevented them from just getting up and taking off, settling all their accounts in such a short time, packing up and moving out. It wasn't like they could all just hop on a train and or hop on the next flight out of Rome. It didn't work that way, as I'm sure you're probably aware. So there's good reason to suspect historically and suggest that Paul was writing to, and this is the part I want you to latch on to, so listen up, that Paul was writing to a group of Gentile Christians and reminding them to stay connected to the Jewish communities if at all possible. Yes, the synagogues were growing increasingly antagonistic against Gentile Christians for whatever reasons, for their messianic claims, for their membership claims in Israel, for the religious differences of over who the Messiah was, right? The conflict over, who Jesus was to the Jewish people, that type of stuff. Yes, that's true, but Paul didn't want, as I understand Romans, Paul didn't want the Gentile Christians to think of themselves as separated from the family of Abraham. To be sure, if we read the internal evidence, even in the book of Romans, like say chapter 4, the theology behind what Paul is trying to teach the Gentile Christians, and it culminates in chapters 9 through 11 of Romans, the what Paul is really trying to get them to understand, they, the Gentiles, is that they are part of the same olive tree family that the Jewish people are already part of. Even if the Gentiles exist on a place in the tree that's special to God because of their faith in Messiah, known as the remnant of Israel, they're grafted into Israel and they become partakers with Israel, not overtakers of Israel. That's the important fact that I think Paul wants to establish. To be sure, the evidence of Paul's reliance upon the different parts of the Tanakh that support his arguments about who Jesus is and who Abraham is and the importance of knowing Yeshua as your personal Messiah and the pardon of your sins, fellowshipping of the Holy Spirit and things like that. All of those details theologically are rooted in the Tanakh. That's the Bible that Paul used, the Old Testament. How could Paul have imagined his Gentile Christians to even believe his line of reasoning if they had no connection to the scriptures of Israel at all, if they were separated from the synagogue communities? It's a very strong logical argument, in my opinion. Paul appeals to the scriptures of Israel over and over again. I think quite a few authors have recognized Bible commentaries that he uses quotes from the book of from the Tanakh itself more than any other book. And so there's a reason why this is called his magnum opus, right? His great theological treatise. And how can he support his arguments if he believes that the Gentile Christians have thrown out their connection to Israel and Israel scriptures? And do we want to imagine for a moment that those synagogue communities just handed over their Torah scrolls to the Gentile Christians and said, hey, guess what? We're leaving. Can you guys take care of these for us while we're gone? Or we decided to sell these to you because we don't have any room to pack them? No. Torah scrolls were one of the most precious items to Jewish people, have always been and always will be. And so you can imagine that they found a way to smuggle those out or take them with them. They weren't prevented, as far as we can tell, from keeping their belongings when Claudius said, get up and get out. He didn't say, leave all that you have behind, as far as we know. So it's unlikely they would have been handing those scrolls over to Gentile Christians and said, hey, you guys can have these. That means the Gentile Christians didn't really have anything to rely on unless they still had connections to some Jewish people who were still around in Rome. And so I suppose that there was still a strong enough Jewish community there that Paul could appeal to the Gentile Christians to stay connected to those synagogue communities, particularly also with the task of reaching out and witnessing to them.